Hello, I'm Mr. Nijjhar, a lecturer in metallurgy, metal. I'm a scientist. I'm a new skin that contains new wine. And I studied Bible in 1982 and wrote the exposition of Matthew, parables of the Matthew. And there was a most difficult one, Matthew 19. And first I had a wrong interpretation, and when I start writing it down, the correct one come. In the description I have put that the correct version, which I improved upon years after finding some new thing, you add it up, that is, you renew your inner man every day. And this is the temple of God, and God is inside me. If I'm not a greedy man, if I'm a thief, a greedy man, Satan is here, God is out. Judas Iscariot used to steal money from the purse, which is the same thing stealing money from the church purse as salaries. These people with the dog collar, they don't work for God, they work for mammon. A person who works for God, he works like St. Paul, a tent maker, farmer, or some other jobs he's doing. Only when he does the work of God, because God is freely received, freely given, so you don't charge money, and you rather pay to the church or take money out of the church, opposite to what the priest was doing. Priests, they went to the university or study theology, and when they were qualified, like St. Paul, Saul turned Paul, and when they qualified as rabbis, they charged money from the customer, tithe. But when you are royal priest, you don't pay money. You get it from our supernatural Father, because no man can give you gospel. It's gospel received from Him only. So that only to the living people, not the dead in letters. Many people read Bible like a novel, and then they carry it, but Bible is forbidden by Christ Jesus. He said, when you're going on a preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoe, no two tunic, and no script. Script means scripture. Bible is forbidden. They are letters. Our covenant with Jesus is of Holy Spirit, and which is here I show you. Here is John the Baptist, baptizing in water. This is below. And he baptized them in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father Yahweh. And those who found out that if they become Jew outwardly, then they break their covenant with Abraham. Abraham was Semitic race, not a Jew. Otherwise the people of Ishmael would have been Jew. So the people of spirit come here, and they had the Holy Spirit, and they were seeking this narrow gate leading to the royal kingdom of God. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. Law means scripture, and prophets were till John the Baptist. No prophet after that. So prophets are moral teachers concerned with your physical body, and not with your spiritual self. Spiritual self is the regime of Christ. So unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel. So that's why Jesus said that Matthew's place, when they came, hey, your disciples don't say prayer and fasting. Whereas the John's and Pharisee and Sadducee disciples, they pray and fast. Why not yours? Then Jesus told them, so far they have Christ in their heart, they do not need to pray. When Christ is gone and they have become Christians of the book, then they will pray and fast as they are doing today. So you can see the covenant of our covenant of our covenant is not of the letters. Letters were up to here. John the Baptist is holding scripture. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And after that, you know, we enter this where our soul is concerned. So here he turned the people into their tribal seed. Some were Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, so and so. Seed can't bear fruit. Seed has to be turned into plant, and that becomes Christ born. And that means you must kill the ego, ego of the seed. When you kill the ego, you then overcome the arrows. Arrows is the tribal love between people of the same tribe. As English, you know, English love English. If a Nigerian or Indian come, they hate him, calling racist. So they become racist, you know. So you must bury the ego of your seed, that you are a white man, black man or brown man, and turn it into plant. Plant will, then you become solitary. Graft that plant to true vine, Christ Jesus. So plant is the, represents your spiritual self. Here your soul is concerned. Celestial world above, celestial world of sadhus, Metallurgy. Sadhus don't have tribe. If you ask them, what is your tribe? Sadhu will tell you, I became a sadhu. Tribe, we don't have tribe. They are purely spiritual. So spiritual, spiritual, explicit, and the tribal identity becomes implicit in the plant. From it, if you are wheat plant, or a wheat plant, wheat seed, you grow it, the wheat plant will come. So wheat plant will tell you that, my origin is wheat. Same maize plant will come. So that becomes implicit, you know, when it's turned into plant. The seed is gone. So plant is there, that plant is grafted here. In here, we have one father and we are all his sons. Soul is concerned, not the physical body. So here there are neither male, not female, not Jew, not Gentile. Soul represents our Father. So we are the sons of the Most High. Whether in flesh you are female or a male. Even your father, when you enter into this world, and son, grandmother and wife, when they enter into this world or go to the church, they all become brethren and no more the social relationship. So people, you know, go to church. This knowledge of our celestial, super celestial above, where Jesus came from. So this knowledge is hardly known to any. So that's why people don't know the royal kingdom of God. This is the royal kingdom of God. And here John the Baptist created kingdom of heaven here in law and order. Rabbis created it, and here the royal kingdom of God, which is within your own heart. Here it is. So this is the kingdom of heaven and hell in law and order. So the Rabbis, they are the ruler. Alright? And here is the royal kingdom of God which is within your own heart, not outside. Remember, Jesus, when before Pilate, the Jewish people took advantage of his proclaiming the royal kingdom. Royal kingdom means you don't charge money. Freely you see, freely you give. Here you charge tithe. The priest charged tithe. As they became partial and hypocrite, that's why Jesus told them that you take tenth of everything, but the duty you do is you don't do justice to the people. You are partial, doing favor to the rich people and making the poor the poorer. And today the ombudsman and other people, you know, they are not impartial. They work for the money, mammon master, their client. They support them and not the general public. I have experience of them, and if somebody wants to know, I can give him the cases to investigate. So here you are, the kingdom of heaven and hell. That's what the dishonest people call kingdom of hell. Honest people, with the finger of God, you get the peace for giving. Royal kingdom of God is here. So it is of heart and not outside. That's what when Pilate asked Jesus, they are calling you a king. What type of king you are? Then Jesus told him, are you calling me king because the other people say, or are you calling because you yourself believe in it? Then Pilate said, how can you say that? If your own people, Jewish people, they are calling you king, not me. You are one, not a Jew. That means he was impartial. And when Jesus told him that if my kingdom was outside like yours, the soldiers would have come to fight against you, but mine is inside my own heart, here, in my heart, not outside. And when Pilate understood what type of king he was, the truth, then he told the Jewish people, hey, look, he has nothing done wrong. You are just jealous of him. He wanted to release him. But they shouted more and more. When they too much shouting, they said, okay, I have done my justice. If you are not happy, take him away and do your own justice. And he washed his hand under sun, primary source of light. That had nothing to do with the blood of this man, innocent man. And then he handed them over, dressed as their king, with the cloth, king of the Jews. That means they proclaimed him as the king, and not what I said so. So you can see how the people are, you know, the people, priests and churches, they have no knowledge of such things. These priests, to get rid of them, Jesus died on the cross. So here's my book, and you can read it. So to get rid of these priests, Jesus died on the cross, and he openly, here is the John the Baptist, the witness to the light, moon and star here, like mullahs in the mosque, all here. Here is the Islam of Allah. Allah is primary source of light and not a secondary source of light. So here is the Islam in submission to the will of Allah, which Jesus preached. I have come to do the will of my Father, not my will. That is called Islam. And here mullah do their own will, fatwa. This is Islam of Satan, and it is bearing fruit now. People are being killed, and more killing will take place. Unless you preach gospel, do you tell them the real Islam of Allah? Allah is here. there's a mullah. This is Inch Mullah Islam. And here is Inch Allah Islam. Inshallah. So here you have a direct approach to God. Nobody can stand between man and God. Anybody stand between man and God, he is Antichrist. Pope is Antichrist. Doctor the priest are Antichrist. And all these people who are priests, they say they are the guide, you know, and this and that, they are all Antichrist. Matthew 19, in the description you will find the full version. So prayer and fasting used to be under this priest to the once born people, disciples of the rabbi, but it is a duty. The root of the word disciple is discipline. The once born people were disciplined by teaching them the moral law of Moses. So when the moral laws were taught, then they had disciples. But in Christ Jesus, John the Baptist was the last prophet. Law and prophets were in John the Baptist. No, after that one, our covenant is of Holy Spirit with God, with Christ Jesus. Through Holy Spirit you understand gospel. No Holy Spirit inside you, no gospel. So this is the temple of God. The priest, royal priest, is sitting in here in the heart. And that is God lives in here, royal priest lives in here, called Emmanuel. God is with us. Yahweh is in heaven. Yahweh is the Lord of nature. Potter, this pot was made by Yahweh. The soul inside me is of Elohim. Allah Abram. So here is the Yahweh and his nature. So this is the menorah. These are Yahweh pot. Social, ecumenical, political affairs. And middle candle is of Elohim. Allah Abram, the light. Supernatural. So our soul is supernatural. Our body is natural. You can see with two naked eye. The supernatural you have to perceive, not seen. That's why Jesus said they see but not perceive. Oral Torah is the one that will make you perceive the supernatural things. And that knowledge of Oral Torah comes from our supernatural Father God, by the grace. If you are not greedy, if you are greedy, he won't give you anything. So the doctor and priest working per moment, they get nothing. So what I can tell you, they are not an iota of this thing. And they are antichrist and they call me heretic. Because you speak the gospel truth. So prayer you don't say, because before it comes to your lip, he already knows what in you, what is in your heart. So you don't need to babble. The only these rabbi Pharisees, Sadducees, they babble at the crossroads and other things to attract attention, to say that, oh, he's a very good rabbi, then people will give him money. And he is very happy to make money like that. We are not concerned with money, because one of our brother, he went to Iraq area to cure some people of foot and other diseases. When he had cured them and wanted to come back, and the king of the Iraq, he wanted to give him present, you know. He refused to take it. He said, we have given our own, why should we take a present of the others? Of the blood money. And that is how it is, you know, the royal priests, they don't take money. So anybody who take money in the name of Christ Jesus, he is Antichrist. So you have to be careful. So he will study pray and fast. And prayer and fast, he doesn't understand our Father. Our own Father understands his language, which is gospel. If you preach gospel, then he is happy. And then you yourselves are saved, and you save other people from the disaster like what happened in France, the priests getting killed or this and that. So these things will be common in the coming years. Atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023 when Israel is 75 years old. So you don't be bothered, you know. If you know the gospel, you enter the fold of our supernatural Father, one fold, one shepherd, headed by Christ Jesus, and not headed by Pope or these dark-colored beasts, the Antichrist. So many videos I have put, and it is no good to repeat again and again. So people who are predestined of our supernatural Father, they know it. This chart, this one, you should copy it. It's found in my description. And understand it. If you can translate into different languages or improve upon my design, I can help. If you can help me with technical, I've written a book also. And every chapter is written. I just needed graphic, you know, something. So that to publish it. So anybody interested in Christianity, real Christianity of heart, then I am here. I don't thumb the Bible. Bible is Antichrist. When you go on a preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Script means Bible, which is the Jewish leaven. Written Torah, Jewish level, and which make you orphan. Without that Bible, you can't open your mouth. And we have the Holy Spirit, and with the Holy Spirit, our covenant is up with Christ Jesus, and we open our mouth without any Bible or anything. It all comes from the heart. That's why St. Thomas, St. Paul said, that gospel cannot be written down in ink or paper, but over the living tablet of heart through logical reasoning, which you have to do it. And then you can explain to other people. That's why the Samaritan woman said, St.Photina, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything from the bottom line truth. That's St. Thomas said, although we are solitary, but we are one accord, because all of us have learned the subject from the basic, bottom line truth. Our Father God blesses you. So don't waste your time on prayer and fasting. Our Father is not deaf and dumb. He's inside here. He's listening to everything. Say things which make our Father happy, and not say anything which make it angry. Remember the 10 virgins? 5 of them went there, who had oil in their lamps. They said, Father, Father, Abba, Abba. And the Father opened the door, and they were welcomed. The other 5 who were psychic. First one, pneumatic. The other, psychic. They went there. They wanted to boost his ego. He said, Lord, Lord, Lord. He came outside. He said, I'm spirit. I set people free in spirit. I don't lord over people. Go and bloody get lost. So he kicked them away from the door, and come another time when you have learned who the hell I am. So our Father of our soul is Father. He is not Lord. We are his son, representing him in preaching gospel, which is his light. The Lord Yahweh is demiurge, and so are the scriptures, which are moral law. They are demiurge. So when you have this, read the scripture, you learnt it from your rabbi, and without rabbi you can't speak. You have to see this thing was told by my professor, this and that. Then you are an orphan. We are not orphan in Christ Jesus. We have been given the key to the treasury, of our supernatural Father. So we have plentiful treasures, and we are told to spend as we like it with the grace of our supernatural Father. So exercise love called agape. Eros in Moses, agape in spiritual, filial love when you discuss the gospel. Two or three sitting together, our brother Christ Jesus is among us. He is not our Lord, he is our anointed elder brother. And here is the storge love, family love, which was at Pentecost when they all got the Holy Spirit with capital S. Peter was once born, all of a sudden he got Holy Spirit with capital S, the very Spirit of God. That made him the twin brother of Jesus. Oh, he was most drunk with the new wine. And he started preaching gospel. And before that, he used to be quiet man, not speak anything. And that from that on, he became an orator. From the heart it was coming, not from the book. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, the unconditional divine love on international basis. Moses created arrows in the wilderness that lifted the rift between the two brethren who was fighting in Egypt. And he said, oh, don't fight. He said, aggressor, who made you the a judge or arbitrator? Get lost. So over there in the wilderness, no more such thing. They all became faithful sons of Abraham, and the land they have left as unfaithful, prodigal sons, that became lush green and fattened calf. And the elder brother, Ishmael said, ah, I have been with you, Father, all the time. You never gave me such a feast, or never made my land so fertile. Why this man, he spent all your money and everything? Then Father said to him, he was lost, we have found him. So that is the how we enjoy our friendship, brothership. We are brethren. And when you are learn more and more, you become friend. So in Jesus, no disciples. The root of the disciple is discipline. You discipline natural boys by teaching him the moral of Moses. We are not under law. We don't learn Moses' law. We are under spirit. And so, under spirit, we exercise love called agape. Under flesh, we love called arrows. That's what he created Moses in wilderness. Make them faithful sons of Abraham and give them the power to go free. They were set free. They are special people, you know, the chosen people. In Abram, brought from the Iraq area, a cradle of humanity. So he was like Adam and Eve. Sarah was Eve. And promised and Garden of Eden, living in the company of the Creator Yahweh. That is the Jewish God, Yahweh. Yahweh is the word from two words, Yah from to sire, who means of him, sire of him. They don't write his name. That is all hypocrisy. So our Father God blesses you, and in Jesus, we are no more slaves, we are no more orphans, we are free men, we are the sons of the Most High, and we have the key to his royal treasury. God blesses everyone. So, Potomac was not far away, because he talked of tribulation in the world.